Welcome to Great Hymns of the Faith. My name is John Fraser. I'm your host. We are going to begin our program today with a great hymn of faith. It is one of my favorites. It's called To God Be the Glory. And of course, the author is none other than Fanny Crosby. This is just one of about 8,000 hymns that she wrote. And of course, the one who's responsible for the music is none other again than Howard Doane. Enjoy. To God be the glory. That was To God Be the Glory by none other than Fanny Crosby. And we're going to feature another hymn of Fanny Crosby's. And there's an interesting little story behind this hymn as to how it came about. It's reported that on one occasion, Fanny held a special service at a prison for men. Now, much was hoped for from this particular meeting. And as Fanny was speaking, and her very blindness gave her power, first one prisoner and then another prisoner would interrupt by calling on the good Lord not to pass me by. Fanny was so touched by the pleas of these men that she could not get the thought of them out of her mind. Indeed, she said later, "I wrote the lines with the men's pleading wail still in my ears. Pass me not, O gentle Savior."
Oh,
Henry W. Baker, in the year 1868, put pen to paper, and the result was a hymn that was sung at the funeral service of Diana, Princess of Wales, in Westminster Abbey, London, on September the 6th, 1997. Do you remember the name of that hymn? Hey, it's called "The King of Love, My Shepherd Is."
Shepherd is, whose goodness faileth never. I nothing lack if I am his, and he is mine forever. Where streams of living water flow, my ransomed soul he leadeth, and where the verdant pastures grow, with food celestial feedeth. Perverse and foolish oft I strayed, but yet in love he sought me, and on his shoulder gently laid, and home rejoicing brought me. In death's dark veil I fear no ill, with thee, dear Lord, beside me. Thy rod and staff my comfort still, thy cross before to guide me. And so through all the length of days, thy goodness faileth never. Good Shepherd, may I sing thy praise within thy house forever.
The prophet Jeremiah, in chapter 10, verses 12 and 13, writes, "God made the earth by his power." Perhaps Isaac Watts took that very text and came up with the beautiful hymn called "I Sing the Mighty Power of God." The music is a traditional English tune arranged by Ralph Vaughan Williams in the year 1906. "I Sing the Mighty Power of God."
I sing the mighty power of God that made the mountains rise, that spread the flowing seas abroad and built the lofty skies. I sing the wisdom that ordained the sun to rule the day. The moon shines full at his command, and all the stars obey. I sing the goodness of the Lord that filled the earth with food. He formed the creatures with a word and then pronounce them good. Lord, how thy wonders are displayed where'er I turn my eyes. If I survey the ground I tread or gaze upon the skies, there's not a plant or flower below but makes thy glories known. And clouds arise and tempests blow by order from thy throne. While all that borrows life from thee is ever in thy care, and everywhere that we can be, thou God art present there.
Both the words and the music of our next hymn are by Clallam B. McAfee. The year was 1903. His text probably came from Isaiah chapter 40, verse 11. He gathers the lambs in his arms and carries them close to his heart. The occasion for this hymn was that McAfee had just lost two young nieces, and this hymn was sung for the benefit of his brother and family. Enjoy, Near to the Heart of God. Christian Henry Bateman, 1813 to 1889. He was the minister of Richmond Place Congregational Church in Edinburgh, Scotland. He later served in congregational pastorates at Hopton, Yorkshire, and Reading, Berkshire. He then took holy orders and served as curate of St. Luke's in Jersey. He authored the hymn, Come Christians, Join and Sing.
Alleluia.
Joseph H. Gilmore, a young minister in the Baptist tradition, was giving an exposition of the 23rd Psalm to members of his Bible class. The year was 1862, and what struck Gilmore more so than ever before was the phrase, "He leadeth me." And from that phrase, found in the 23rd Psalm, Gilmore composed the words to a hymn of the same name, "He leadeth me." Both the words as well as the music of our next hymn come from a traditional spiritual, perhaps based on a verse found in the book of Job, chapter 12, and it's verse 10. In his hand is the life of every creature and the breath of all mankind. Here now is the late George Beverly Shea singing, "He's got the whole world in his hands."
The sun and the moon in his hands. He's got the wind and the rain in his hands. He's got the big round world in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands.
He's got the sinner man in his hands. He's got the sinner man in his hands. He's got the whole wicked world in his hands.
He's got the whole world in his hands.
He's got the tiny little
baby in his hands. He's got that tiny little baby in his hands. He's got that wee tiny baby right in his hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. He's got you and me in his hands. He's got you and me in his hands. He's got you and me, brother, the whole world in his hands.
It really wasn't that long ago that we celebrated the advent of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. God has sent his Son to this earth in the form of a little child. But that child grew up. That child went to the temple and listened to the questions that were being asked of the teachers there. And he responded with answers to many of those questions that were asked of him. He later went on and trained his disciples to go into all the world and preach the gospel. And we also know, of course, that our Lord was crucified on the cross. He died for our sins, but he rose again and he ascended into heaven. But what did he say? He said, I will come again and receive you unto myself. The Lord Jesus Christ will return in the fullness of his glory at his second advent. Now, here once again is George Beverly Shea singing, When He Comes.
Every ear shall hear the sound of angels when he comes, when he comes. Every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that he is Lord when he comes. Him, really him, the one and only, when he comes, when he comes, glorified and transformed, I'll arise at his call, and I'll be ready when he comes. His beautiful feet upon this mountain, and the dead of all the ages who believe on him will rise. And I'll be one in the first resurrection when he comes.
When Jesus comes, the scriptures tell us that every eye shall see him and every knee shall bow, that God's children shall rise to meet the Lord in the air. Here now is a gospel selection called We, that's God's Children, Shall Rise. I hope you enjoy it. It was great having you with us today, folks, and I do hope that you enjoyed the selection of hymns that I was able to share with you. And as I have mentioned on other occasions, if you haven't heard your favorite hymn in a long time, just drop me a note. And there are two ways that you can do that. You can write, that's sending an email, and my email address is doulos, doulosrev at gmail.com. Tell me your hymn, and I'll do my best to see if I can't put it on the air for you. Or you can send a regular note by mail. Yeah, that's the old-fashioned way, isn't it? Pastor John Fraser, 4072 River Crest Circle, Leesburg, Leesburg, Florida, 34748. And share the hymn that you would like to hear. Until we meet again, God bless.